Hi, I'm Sydney.
And I'm Joey, and we're PMs on the PowerShell team.
So, Joey, what are you working on over there?
I was just doing some housekeeping here with an Ubuntu VM I've got up in Azure. I was gonna do some little tech chores here, hop on over. And of course, you know, I gotta fire up PowerShell since you know, we are on the PowerShell team.
Joey, is that the update notification? Have you not upgraded to RC2 yet?
I guess I've been forgetting. Yeah, maybe I don't use this VM too often. Yikes. Well, I should probably do an update here. So,
yeah, definitely.
Definitely want a sudo apt update, but this actually is a great opportunity for me to show off the new pipeline chain operators. Have you heard about these?
I have, but I don't totally understand how they work. Could you explain them again?
Yeah, so there's two operators here. You've got the and, and then the pipe, which is like an or. So I'll show off the first one here, this and. So let me type this out, and then I'll show you what's going on. So basically, you've got this command on the left-hand side, and the and says, hey, for the command on the right-hand side, I'm actually not going to run that command unless the first command is executed successfully.
Okay.
So if I get a dollar question mark set to true, which means that command was able to execute without throwing an error, then we're actually going to do the install here on the right. So first thing, update the apt repo cache, and then update PowerShell.
Very cool. And you know what that updating the repo cache reminds me of?
What's that?
PowerShell get 3.0 coming soon.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's going to have a local update cache as well. So we're going to have to be teaching users how to use this this exact pattern here with PowerShell get v3.
Totally. Yeah, and I can see why those operators are so popular. It seems very useful.
It's very useful, especially in test and build environments and that sort of thing, when you want to make sure that all your steps are completing successfully before you move on to new ones. So it looks like we were able to update here. And if I run upgrade, excuse me, and we go ahead and execute this, and we should get the latest version of PowerShell. So you'll see that RC2 is downloading. We were able to update the repo caches successfully up here, this hit, and then we're going to get the download and install. Awesome. So of course, you know, I'm going to have to restart PowerShell to get the new version. I'm still here stuck in RC1. But if I go ahead and switch over to PWSH preview, you'll see, boom, there I am on RC2. No more update notification.
Awesome. Very cool.
That's awesome. So what have you been working on, Sydney?
Well, I've actually also been working on playing with some of the new features in PowerShell 7.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Do you want to see my screen?
Yeah. Yeah. Wait, what's all that blue you got over there?
Oh, this? This is the Visual Studio Code PowerShell extension in ISC mode. It's one of the features we recently added. It gives you some of the shortcuts from the ISC, and it also gives you that familiar color scheme.
I love it. I love it. I loved the ISC. It's really, really awesome to see us bringing some of that back.
If you want to flip into it, just Control-Shift-P, open the command palette, and you can enable and disable it as much as you'd like.
Nice.
Yeah, so do you remember OutGridView?
Yeah, it was super popular in Windows PowerShell, but we haven't had it working for a while, right?
Right, but with .NET Core 3.1, we've actually been able to bring back a lot of the Windows commandlets, including OutGridView.
That's awesome. Can you show it to me working here?
For sure. So here, I'm grabbing some services. I'm using selection to grab the one I specifically want. Here, I'm grabbing the SSH agent. And then I'm able to restart that service.
Nice. Is this? I hear this is pretty popular with database administrators as well. Is that...
Absolutely. Yeah. Our users in Azure Data Studio with the PowerShell extension absolutely love OutGridView selection, and they're really excited that this is going to be part of PowerShell 7.
That is awesome. I can't wait. Can't wait to see it out there in the wild.
Yeah. Well, can I show you something else cool from PowerShell 7 that I've been working on?
Totally.
Okay. Cool. So, here I'm pulling in some providers, and grabbing their win events.
Okay, so this is you've got a list of ETW providers here. Mm-hmm. You're going to pull all their win events and then stuff them into a variable.
Absolutely. And so ordinarily, I've been using for each object to run this, and so then it sequentially processes each commandlet, each win event, and that's been fine, but it's not been as fast as I would like it to be.
Yeah. So how long did this just take here?
Well, this one just took me 16 seconds.
16 seconds? I think we could do better than that.
I think so, too. Yeah. Luckily, we have for each object parallel, which allows this script block to be processed in parallel.
Nice. So you're actually spinning up a separate run space for each of the providers hitting the pipeline and collecting all of their logs in parallel?
Exactly. So it's still all on my local machine, and it's all in the same PowerShell process, but it's using separate run spaces to speed up the performance.
So how much faster did we get?
We got down to 7 seconds.
Nice.
Yeah, and this is pretty awesome with this task, but imagine the stuff that takes us an hour to run.
Yeah, you'd be, if you're doing twice as fast, that you know, the more logs and the bigger they are, you're just going to get better and better gains.
It's amazing. I can't believe we fit all this stuff into PowerShell 7.
It's crazy. And then we've got all the secrets management and PowerShell Get work that's coming out too, right?
Yeah, a lot of previews to look forward to. Make sure that you're checking aka.ms/psblog for all the latest updates on the things we're working on.
I'll definitely keep my eyes peeled.
Absolutely do.
Until next time.